You're listening to Tim Bulkley's 5-Minute Bible. Jeremiah 11:18 to 12:6. Jeremiah's first complaint. But before that, a word about lament psalms. Lament psalms have a fairly common set of ideas which are expressed in them. They are addressed to God, sometimes just, O God or O Lord, sometimes it's more complicated. They almost always express either a or some complaints. There is a request for help addressed to God. There's usually an affirmation of trust in God, perhaps as thanks for God's past actions, or simply as praise and conviction that God will act. And then there's sometimes a vow that the person will praise God when the trouble is over. This first confession of Jeremiah is a good illustration of both how these speeches are like and that they are unlike lament psalms. Chapter 11 verses 18 to 19 express a situation in need of putting right, but they don't express that situation to God. They're not addressed to God. Jeremiah tells us, his hearers, it was the Lord who made it known to me and I knew, although the next line does suggest that God is also part of the audience, when you showed me their evil deeds. So the address is already somewhat complicated. Then verse 20, but you, Adonai of hosts, who judge righteously, who try the heart and the mind, let me see your retribution upon them, for to you I have committed my cause, is pretty much in one verse a little tiny lament psalm. It's got everything just about that you'd expect in a lament psalm. Then in verse 21 to 23 we get something that we don't get in the book of Psalms. We hear God's reply to Jeremiah's lament. Many scholars imagine that there were such oracles from God as replies to the laments in the Psalms, but we've no evidence one way or the other about that because they're not in the book. In this case, Yahweh's short replies tell how he will act in this case. And how he'll act in this case is basically to wipe them out. This leads on to chapter 12 verse 1. And that's why I won't separate chapter 12 verses 1 to 6 from chapter 11 verses 18 to 23. You will judge rightly, O Lord, when I lay charges against you, or when I lay charges before you, and the Hebrew doesn't distinguish those two. But let me put my case to you, or let me put this case to you. Why does the way of the guilty prosper? Why do all who are treacherous thrive? You plant them and they take root, they grow and bring forth fruit. You're near in their mouths, yet far from their hearts. There's the complaint. But you, O Lord, know me, verse 3. You see me and test me. My heart is with you. Pull them out like sheep for the slaughter, and set them apart for the day of slaughter. How long will the land mourn, and the grass of every field wither, for the wickedness of those who live in it? The animals and birds are swept away, and so people say, he's blind to our ways. See? Just like a lament psalm. Verses 1 to 4 introduce the problem of the lack of correspondence between living a good life and enjoying the good life to live. And that problem is very, very common in laments. It's the heart and soul of the lament. And like the lament psalms, Jeremiah makes the issue personal in verse 3 as well as general in, for example, verse 4. But here's where it gets really complicated. Yahweh's reply to Jeremiah is by no means simple and straightforward. If you race with footrunners and they've wearied you, how will you compete with horses? If in a safe land you fall down, how will you fare in the thickets of the Jordan? For even your kinsfolk and your own family, even they have dealt treacherously with you and are in full cry after you. Don't believe them, though they speak friendly words to you. Okay, Jeremiah, how are you going to respond to that? You're hardly going to be able to trot out the conventional response that you'd expect in a lament psalm. And of course it gets more complicated still, because this is the point at which we expect the lament psalm to finish with its glorious song of praise or whatever. But actually the text of Jeremiah goes on. Verse 7, I have forsaken my house, I've abandoned my heritage, I've given the beloved of my heart into the hands of her enemies. And so on. You see, I think verse 7 and following is meant to cause Jeremiah to reflect on verses 5 and 6. It's all part of Yahweh's response to Jeremiah's complaint. More about all this in the next podcast. See you then. Bye.